Representatives passed a budget bill that would eliminate the family planning program called Title 10 and would bar Planned Parenthood from receiving any federal funding for life-saving preventive health care services.
And so we're standing together because this moves to the Senate now, and we want them to make this right. We want our senators to protect Title 10 and to protect Planned Parenthood and to make sure that they can continue providing care to 5 million Americans who rely on these health centers, on Planned Parenthood health centers for basic care. We're talking about screenings for breast and cervical cancer and testicular cancer. Who thinks it's important to have screenings? What about testing and treatment for sexually transmitted infections? And what about access to birth control?
Family planning is the only federal grant program dedicated solely to providing individuals with comprehensive family planning and related preventive care. It's directed primarily at low-income individuals and offers access to care with sliding fee and free services. In 1969, President Richard Nixon showed interest in family planning and sent a message to Congress. In his message, Nixon wrote, and I quote, "It is my view that no American woman should be denied access to family planning assistance because of her economic condition." End quote. What are family planning services? Kira sort of touched on those, but they include pregnancy tests, birth control counseling, pelvic exams, pap smears, breast exams, testicular exams, all to prevent cancer, fertility counseling, sexually transmitted disease diagnosis and treatment, sterilization services for both men and women, emergency contraception, birth control education and supplies, including IUDs, birth control pills, Implanon, the shot, the patch, condoms, the whole nine yards. And to qualify for the program, all one has to do is meet the eligibility guidelines in terms of income and either be interested in a method of birth control or seeking pregnancy.
The opposition basically says that this funding goes to pay for abortions. And resoundingly, unequivocally, no, that is not true. All federal funding is used for preventive care. The Hyde Amendment, you know, makes sure of that. And it's real important, I think, to point out that the people who are doing this, who are pushing these dangerous policies, for the most part, are people who are opposed to abortion care. And I cannot understand for the life of me why someone opposed to abortion would do everything in their power to take away funding that helps people prevent unintended pregnancies. You know, if this passes the Senate and passes, unintended pregnancies and abortion rates will absolutely go up. It doesn't make any sense.
So wanna have fun now.